Hello, everyone. I'm Julian Bersano. I'm the CEO of Klimber. Previously, I worked in New York as Vice President for Marketing Intelligence Strategy. And before that, I was also an entrepreneur. We co-founded with Chris the first insurance aggregator in Latin America 18 years ago. And now we are back with our new project, which is Klimber. We are launching a digital insurer with our first product, that it's a life insurance product. And we are partnering with Prudential for this. We are starting as a digital MGA. And we also have very good partners in the region already. We look up to companies such as Shongan and Lemonade. We think the future lies in gathering data to analyze and to also be prepared for machine learning. So we partner with the biggest media company in Latin America or in Argentina, maybe one of the biggest in Latin America, which is Grupo Clarín. Together with Chris, we assembled a very senior team, a very good team. I'll let you, Chris, talk about that.
Thank you. First of all, guten Tag. Als Deutsch-Argentinier freut es mich sehr, unsere Firma öffentlich weltweit in meiner zweiten, meinem zweiten Heimatland vorstellen zu können. Having said that, I'm introducing myself. My name is Christian Elbert. I'm in charge of legal and regulatory. I'm an attorney. My background is on corporate and IT law. I have a master in law and economics. And I want to be very brief, not to steal you the opportunity for you to explain the technology, but I want to convey two principal ideas of Klimber. First one is the idea of balance. We have an experienced team in different fields. Many of us are former AIG executives who have worked in the US, in Japan, and of course in the region, in Latin America. Senior programming personnel and members, and members with legal background. One of our idea or core values is to get or to offer affordable insurances. So that's the music, but it takes basically two to tango for us. So we believe that true innovation is only achievable not only with innovative technology, but also with the joining of an active legal team who helps opening the paths in the regulatory ecosystems that we find, and smart contracts, of course. Then the second idea is to fight poverty. This, we believe strongly in the idea that affordable insurance can be a tool to include many people that today are excluded from the insurance markets, and that insurance as such is a way to help people, to assist persons that today are really not covered, which might have a big impact in developing countries such as ours. A person who has an accident may really fall off the grid. And so having the access to affordable insurance is not only hopefully a profitable enterprise, but also a tool to include people and to provide resilience and inclusion for many people, 650 million in our area. So now, without further ado, we would start the presentation of the tool. So there you go.
Thank you.
Julian?
So what you'll see here is basically, as you know, we are we like to say of ourselves that we are a technology company, not only an insurance company. So we built our whole platform from scratch. We built our platforms, our quote engines, as you are seeing now. This is our life insurance quote engine. But we also built several systems on the back end, such as our own CRM, our own policy admin system. And we did this because we think that we need to innovate throughout all our back end if we want to be truly affordable in the future, because we use chatbots, for example, our own chatbot. You will see it now. Our chatbot needs to be integrated to our CRM, to our policy admin system, in order to work and to have the power to change things. Once you are talking to or chatting with a chatbot, the chatbot needs to have the power to change things for you. For example, if you want to cancel your policy, the chatbot needs to have the power to access the CRM. So we started from zero to make sure everything was connected on the back end. And we also did that because we wanted to have our own systems control our code, be safe in that sense, and also be ready for machine learning, gathering all our data into one single place. What you are seeing here is the process of buying a life insurance product. We are still changing the last things here because we are launching before 2 weeks. The idea here is to present a very simplified version of what an insurance product is that you can, of course, personalize to your own needs. And what we are seeing now is the back office. While you are buying, this is our what we call our contact center mitigation software. This is where all the chats that are happening in our website, through Telegram, through Skype, or through Facebook Messenger concur into one place. While the customer chats, we get all the different conversations, and we build algorithms into our platform that enable an operator to intelligently prioritize those conversations that need to have an intervention of the operator. As we progress and our chatbot learns, we hope that the chatbot will be able to solve as much conversations as possible. But in the meantime, we have a good team of operations on the back end that will take charge if needed. As you can see there, that conversation turned red because the word accident popped up. So, and the word accident for our algorithms is an immediate alert for the manual operator on our contact center. Now you'll see, well, the operator can intervene in that specific conversation in order to make sure that our customer experience through chatbot stays the way we want to stay. After this, you are going to see the back end of the chatbot itself. We created our own chatbot system that we can program and keep improving every day. On our contact center, we have not the typical contact center operator, but a team of people whose main role is to improve our chatbot. So every time they are intervening and finding content that didn't suit our customers' expectations, they go into the module you see next, and they introduce that content to the chatbot to make sure the next time the chatbot answers, it's a better answer. We have experience in machine learning. Also, several of our team members, while in New York, we developed a stock trading robot. And we can say we have experience there because we lost some money, Christian. So,
I want to forget.
But we want to use machine learning, and we have our own engine for machine learning, and we will use it for risk, for fraud detection, and for marketing purposes. We don't want our chatbot to be fueled by our machine learning purpose engine, because we want to keep the content very curated. We don't believe in a robot that can say anything. We investigated a lot of different things that happened there, and we didn't find a good experience when you let your chatbot learn anything. So we have a curated content. We have more than 3,000 already, 3,000 pieces of content that are, of course, variabilized or turned into natural language understanding. But we want to keep the content very curated to give the right answers. So my time is running up. Mm-hmm. We are a technology company. We want to keep our code within our grasp. We want to know and exactly every line of code that we developed. And in that way, we feel we will be safe. Security is a very important priority for us. So anyway, feel free to visit us on our booth. That's it for now. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.